reading is from Ephesians chapter 1, verses 11 to 23. In Christ we have also obtained an inheritance, having been destined according to the purpose of Him who accomplishes all things according to His counsel and will, so that we, who are the first to set our hope on Christ, might live for the praise of His glory. In Him, you also, when you had heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and had believed in Him, were marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. This is the pledge of our inheritance for redemption as God's own people, to the praise of His glory. I have heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love toward all the saints, and for this reason I do not cease to give thanks for you as I remember you in my prayers. I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know Him, so that with the eyes of your heart and mind you may know what is the hope to which He has called you, what are the riches of His glorious inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of His power for us who believe, according to the working of His great power. God put this power to work in Christ when He raised Him from the dead and seated Him at His right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. And He has put all things under His feet, and has made Him the head over all things for the church, which is His body, the fullness of Him who fills all in all. The word of the Lord.
We have inherited this covenant of baptism from those in ages past who shared their faith and faithfulness. So today we draw together a wider community of believers, all the saints of God, the newly baptized, and those who from their labors rest, who have fought the good fight, and who have gained the crown. Recalling that we have been sealed in the Spirit and sustained by the Savior's body and blood, with all the baptized, the old and young, the weak and the strong, we praise you, O God. With all your holy people and all who walked the way of the cross, we glorify you, O God. And holy God, we honor these new generations of the faithful and honor our ancestors in faith and members of our families and friends. We'll sing together our hymn. Blessed are they. The words are printed in your bulletin, but they're also on the screen. Let us remember and give thanks for those who have been baptized here in this place since All Saints Sunday of last year. Those that you've gathered into the family of the church and in the path of discipleship. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. So as I read the names of those recently baptized, we'll ask the families just to come forward, make your way up to the front, and in honor and celebration and remembrance of your loved one that's been baptized, we'll just invite you to light a candle at the baptismal font and then place the candle around the font. And because we have two services, it's always tricky because, like you, most people don't attend both services, but we'll just have our acolyte light the candle if there are no families that come forward. And then we also have on the screen, we've got pictures of their actual baptisms as well, which is kind of fun to remember that. So God of all the saints, we give you thanks and praise for Bethany Renee Whitmore. God of all the saints, we give you thanks and praise for Maren Leanne Anderson. God of all the saints, we give you thanks and praise for Leighton John Wager. God of all the saints, we give you thanks for Cole Alexander Phillips Kelty. God of all the saints, we give you thanks for Jason Donald Cross. God of all the saints, we give you thanks for Carter Thomas Dawson. God of all the saints, we give you thanks for Hannah Mae Dawson. God of all the saints, we give you thanks for Kenton Kenneth Sather. God of all the saints, we give you thanks and praise for Liam Avery Schuler. God of all the saints, we give you thanks and praise for Sarah Hoyt. God of all the saints, we give you thanks and praise for Emery Joe Wager. God of all the saints, we give thanks and praise for Tenley Ann Brown. God of all the saints, we give you thanks and praise for Holden Wistel. God of all the saints, we give you thanks and praise for Gabriel West Seibert. God of all the saints, we give you thanks and praise for Blake Paul Nelson. God of all the saints, we give you thanks and praise for Myla Elizabeth Laws. God of all the saints, we give you thanks and praise for Belle Eileen Rambert. God of all the saints, we give you thanks and praise for Ainsley Nicole Tuff. God of all the saints, we give you thanks and praise for Jackson Allen. And we pray. Throughout their lives, oh God, you have been following all these baptized, and you've been calling and coaxing and working through many people and experiences to bring them to you. And you have been there always longing to make children of earth citizens of heaven. So today we rejoice because these newly baptized have heard your call and now they follow you. And today we claim your promise that all who is baptized shall be saved. Watch over all those we have named before you and all your children in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now we'll sing our hymn as we prepare to give thanks and remember the saints that are now gone. and blessed are you who weep now, for you will laugh. Jesus named the blessed ones, and so on this day of remembrance, let us recall and give thanks for the blessed ones who have gone before us. Now, as I read the names of these blessed saints, we ask the family or special friends to come forward and simply light a candle in their honor, and then just hold the candle in front. You'll receive your candle from Jesse, who will be in the front, and then you can light your candle from the back. So let us pray. For your unending love for those who have ended their earthly pilgrimage, whom we have committed at Grace Lutheran Church into your loving arms since All Saints of last year, O Lord, we give you our utmost thanks and praise. Amen.
Worker and who knew endurance.
blessed be Merrill Johnson, who was devoted to his family and friends, enjoyed laughter, and appreciated the gifts of God's grace in his life. Let us now bow our heads in prayer as we remember these blessed saints of our church and our community. Living God, we give you thanks for calling forth these blessed ones. O God, keep them forever in your arms. May they stay forever in our hearts. Because of their living, teach us to live faithfully. And for the safekeeping of all of our loved ones who have died in your tender care, whom we now name before you in the silence of our hearts. Rest eternal, grant to them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. Amen. You may extinguish your candles, and you may keep those candles. May you light them in your homes this coming year. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you. got a few more coming, it looks like. Good morning. Do you guys have dragons?
Oh, whoa. That'll wake you up in the morning.
Here, have a seat. So I have, what are these?
Sticks.
Sticks, yeah. So I've got a whole bunch of sticks in this bag. So I'm going to have, I need one volunteer. Who can volunteer for me? All right, do you want to come over here? Okay, now I want you with all your strength, okay, to try to break that branch. Bend, 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 bend. Good job! See? Breaking one branch is pretty easy. I don't know about this big one, but probably still could be done. Now, let's try to put all the sticks together. Do you guys have a lot of sticks in your yard? Yeah, that's what I did this morning. I was out collecting sticks. So now we have a whole bunch of sticks. All right? So I'm going to try to break them. I can't break them. Here, Mom, you can try with me.
Go and live in what is known as the
Great North, Alaska. I had the opportunity to go up to Alaska for a summer and work seasonally in Denali National Park. It was a great opportunity for somebody that just graduated college, needed a break, and I was really discerning going to seminary during that time. So it was a nice break to head up there, met some amazing people. The parks up there hire college kids to work, and it was just an amazing experience. My first week up in Alaska was spent doing training. We had people come in and talk to us about all that the park had to offer for tourists. And we also learned a lot about safety in Alaska. The one thing that stuck out to me the most was when the gentleman from the DNR came in and he talked to us about the importance of if you're going to go out on a hike, no matter how long or how short of the hike, you have to go in groups. Because Alaska is known for its beauty, and it's known for the midnight sun and the northern lights, but it's also known for the numerous deadly encounters that people have with wildlife. And so this gentleman from the DNR just drilled it into us that you have to be in a group. The idea is if you're in a group and you encounter a bear or any of the other wild animals that live there, they're more likely to be scared if you're with a group of people than just yourself. You become vulnerable when you're by yourself. And aside from the wildlife, if you get hurt on the trail or if you get lost, it's good to be in a group. He kept saying this, strength in numbers. That was his slogan. Whenever you think you want to go hiking, remember, strength in numbers. Now this saying, strength in numbers, we hear a lot. Sports teams use it. You're stronger when you play as a team versus playing as a bunch of individuals. People that are in band know that the flute section is strong, but it sounds probably even better when all the other instruments are playing to make the whole piece of music beautiful. Fundraisers use it. They say every dollar counts towards, makes a difference towards achieving our goal. So strength in numbers. In today's lesson, we heard a piece of Paul's letter written to the Ephesians. And although Paul didn't necessarily use that phrase, strength in numbers, he spoke to that same message, that we're stronger in community than we are by ourselves. And the community that we are a part of, that makes us stronger in our faith and stronger in our vocations as Christians, is the community of saints. It's a community that far exceeds this lifetime. It surpasses death and it reaches into the heavenly realm. It's a community that is built on the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. In the time that Paul wrote this epistle to the Ephesians, he had this goal of trying to connect Christians of Jewish heritage to those of Gentile them to the recognition of their commonalities, that they are members of God's community. Being Jew or being Gentile doesn't matter. We're community in one under God. Paul says we come to be part of the inheritance of God's kingdom by entering into God's community in baptism, where we are sealed with the mark of the Holy Spirit. It is in our baptism that we come to be part of the community of God, which includes not just the living believers, but also the believers that have gone before us. The saints, for whom Paul writes, have the riches of God's glorious kingdom among them. Everyone who has claimed faith throughout their lifetime are part of this community, a community defined by God's hope and God's love. During seminary, we are required to work at churches. It's called contextual education. And I had the opportunity, I worked at a church in St. Paul, and I got to witness quite a few baptisms. And it was interesting to me because after these little tiny infants were baptized, the pastor would walk through the pews and introduce them as Saint Miriam or Saint John. He would put Saint in front of their name. And it was kind of jarring at first, like these little tiny infants being called saints. But that pastor was onto something, I think. Because in Paul's understanding, the title Saint belongs to all of those who have been united in Christ. Throughout all of Paul's letters, he routinely calls the people of the churches saints. Because of who they are in Christ, not because of what they have accomplished. This lesson from Paul is very appropriate for today, because today we celebrate All Saints Day. We celebrate God's community made up of people, you, me, everyone, who are simultaneously called saints and sinner. We celebrate the strength of a community that bonds us and connects us so deeply to one another. And this community is the church. And the church is past, present, future. We share our mission and ministry with those who have died and those who will come to carry on our work. When we were washed in the waters of baptism, we were bathed with the waters of eternity. The waters that have flowed through history. As we take part in Holy Communion and come to the table, we are dining with a group of people that far exceeds what our eyes can perceive. A family of ordinary people who have been marked by the extraordinary power of the Holy Spirit and are now called saints. In this community, family is redefined and death has no power anymore. We call this community the church, and it is happening right now. And it is strong because every boundary has been broken. And we stand not alone, but we stand together with the communion of saints. Paul reminds us that sainthood is not a solitary action, but we are saints together. We are saints with one another and with those who have gone before us. We are saints through Christ, who has given us the gift of faith and baptism. In that, we are called to look toward one another and those saints for encouragement and examples as to how to live out a life of faithfulness. Paul writes, I pray that God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him, so that with the eyes of your heart enlightened, you may know what is the hope to which he has called you, what are the riches of his glorious inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power for us who believe according to the working of his great power. Today, as we celebrate being a part of God's community, may we also lift up this prayer that Paul wrote to the Ephesians. May we all, having believed in God's word, come to know and understand his greatness and his power. May we, the church, embrace the strength and the bond of this community and look to one another for an example of faith and faithful living. And may we rejoice, for we have been chosen by God to be in the community of all saints, the past, the present, and the future. Just as a lone hiker is told not to venture into the wilderness alone, we too are called by God to not venture in our journey of faith alone. God calls us to journey with the communion of all saints. For together we are stronger. There is truth in the saying, strength in numbers. On this day, let us give all praise, honor, and glory to God, who has gathered all the saints into community and calls them his beloved children. Amen.
Well, we want to take just a moment during our worship time to welcome our new members that are joining us so that we might be strong together. And so, as I think most of these folks go to the second service, let me just read their names so that we can celebrate together. Joanne Clouse, Paul, Jenny, and Brooke Nelson. If you're here, please stand or make your way up to the front here. Ryan Nelson and Abby Moran, Rachel Mum, Annie, Brianne, and Lucy Golden, and Reese Oxford. I know Reese is here. Reese, you'll come up front, won't you? Reese, did you know the bulletins were sponsored in your honor? Did I mention that? I did, yeah. So here's Reese. I've had Reese in release time since first grade, so I've been Reese's teacher for three years. She's put up with me, haven't you? Yeah, all right. Thank you. So we have Reese, then we have got Zachary Stoffel and Emily Hewling, Nathan Stoffel, and then Rosemary Nag. Most of you probably know these folks, but Reese is Janelle Weeble and Scott Oxendorf's daughter, Janelle Weeble, gospel. Now we ask you to join this community, profess your faith, and confess the faith of the church, the faith in which we baptized. We'll join together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge us.
Thank you.
night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks and broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. And again, after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it for all to drink, saying, this cup is the new covenant of my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. gracious unto you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and grant you peace in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Saints of God, go in peace, serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.